Chanoir mit Double Honors to the Elders and Apostles of Great Wisdom.
Okay.
Chanoir unto the wandered Israelites, which include the Judah's children, the so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Indians, who are oppressed together according to the book of Jeremiah 50 and 33, but to whom so late pertaining to adoption, the giving of the law, the promises, the glory, and the covenants, basically everything in the Bible. No, the heathens in the Bible, okay? According to Romans chapter 9. I say it again, according to Romans chapter 9, written by Paul. And in the whole so-called New Old Testament, but okay. And the so-called Old Testament, you see. So basically this lesson, okay, will be a quick hitter, okay. This is the verse of the day, inspirational image. Call unto me and I will answer thee and shew thee great mighty things which thou knowest not. Yeah, because if you understand that you're an Hebrew Israelite and that there is something coming for you, which means, you know, we are in the world of Esau right now. Let's get that real quick. Okay. The earth is given into the hand of the wicked, Job 9 and 24. He covered the faces of the judges thereof, if not where and who is he? See? And also, Second Ezra 6 and 9, for Esau is the end of the world, Jacob is the beginning of it, that follow it. Okay. Isaiah 13 and 11, and I will punish the world for their evil and the wicked for their iniquity, and I will cause the arrogancy of the proud to cease, and I will lay low the haughtiness of the terrible. See, so this is what happens right now, okay, in the midst of all this, the world war, okay, corona pandemic, oppression of the really Israelites, okay, oppression of our land even, okay. Let's start with Joel 3 and 2. I will also gather all nations and will bring them down into the valley of Jehoshaphat, and I will plead with them therefore my people and for my heritage Israel, you see. So Yahweh really soon, okay, is about to judge these nations, you know, finally, okay, basically the last chapter of it, because judgment already began. It started with us, alright, and it basically, you know, has to stop with us, okay? So how much more these heathens, okay, who don't know him, okay, but talk evil about him, and about his people, and oppressed his people, and killed his people day by day, okay? Whom they have scattered among the nations and parted my land, you see? So they parted his land, which was Israel. Verse 3, and they have cast lots for my people, and have given a boy for an harlot, and sold a girl for wine, that they might drink. Yea, and what have ye to do with me, O Tyre and Sidon, and all the coasts of Palestine? Will ye render me a recompense, and and if ye recompense me swiftly and speedily, will I return your recompense upon your own head. You see, because really, really there is no making good of things, until all these seasons are in captivity. Alright, so remember the words of today, you see, because if you understand that you're an Israelite and you have heathens around you, you understand, or it's wise to understand also that you have basically a higher goal to reach, which is receiving the knowledge, wisdom and understanding of the Bible coming down from the elders and apostles of Great Millstone and Great Millstone only, because there are also other Israelite camps, but they don't teach the truth, and if they mix lies within it. But guess what Yehoshua said, a little bit destroys the whole body, right? So basically, if they have something wrong in their doctrine, it destroys the whole doctrine, because basically you will find more than, and much more. Because you have taken my silver and my gold and have carried into your temples my godly pleasant things, right? 70 AD, they took over Jerusalem, you see, and that's Esau Edom for you, right? Esau is Edom. Genesis 36 and 8, thus dwelt Esau on Mount Seir. Esau is Edom. And these are generations of Esau, the father of the Edomites in Mount Seir, you see. And now I go into my land in their possession. This is where we are right now. Alright, fake truth. Ezekiel 36 and 5, therefore said the Lord Yahweh, Baruch Hashem Yahweh Shai, surely in the fire of my jealousy have I spoken against the residue of the heathen and against all Idumea. Idumea is another name for Esau, or more Edom, Idumea means Edom, which have appointed my land into their possession with the joy of all their heart, with spiteful minds to cast it out for a prey. So you have actually teacher out there believing in Judaism, but at the same time reading verses like this, so clearly they have, or they are heathens, because they would understand it is not possible to have words like this written in the Bible at the same time believing in Judaism and that they are the people of the Lord. That makes no sense. You can look at it how you want, it makes no sense, right? So clearly you have to be a heathen to don't get this. And that's just their lot, and that's good. That's their work. Prophesy therefore concerning the land of Israel, and say unto the mountains and to the hills, to the rivers and to the valleys, thus said the Lord Yahweh, Hashem Yahweh Shai, Hashem Kakodash, behold, I have spoken in my jealousy and in my fury, because ye have borne the shame of the heathen. Therefore said the Lord Yahweh, Hashem Yahweh Shai, Hashem Kakodash, because our people are two-thirds of them, to be more exactly, and to be more exact, are basically in that same wickedness where the heathen are right now covered in darkness, right? Therefore, thus said the Lord Yahweh, Hashem Yahweh Shai, Hashem Kakodash, Kakata. I have lifted up mine hand, surely the heathen that are about you, they shall bear their shame, you see. But ye, O mountains of Israel, ye shall shoot forth your branches and yield your food to my people of Israel, for they are at hand to come, you see. Beautiful, Yapa. Let's go into this. Strangeness of their salvation, because people think, maybe you're an Hebrew Israelite, but that doesn't change anything, Yahweh Shai is no longer on this earth, Jesus Christ, and he will never come back, and when he comes back, what can he do? And as a matter of fact, he will come back with so-called UAPs, which they call ignorantly UFO. And guess what? That's that's your end. Okay, let's get it. Because also they will beam up the elect. And guess what? When here nuclear destruction is right before your eyes, burning you up with your tongue in your mouth, while the 144,000 get beamed up by a chariot, okay, by a UAP, you will see the strangeness of our salvation, okay, and you will be even amazed by it, okay, even when these UAPs also cut off people with laser, okay, you know, kill people, where Yahawashi is riding on, man, okay, he will come back on the real big, big father ship, man, and with masses of other chariots around him, man, and you better get that in your head, man. Wisdom of Solomon 5 and 2. When they see it, they shall be troubled with terrible fear, and shall be amazed at the strangeness of his salvation, so far beyond all that these heathen looked for. Shalom, 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 Yahweh Hashem Shai, Baruch Hashem Kakadosh.